after duhur prayer, the most suitable time to sleep kan. But never mind. So actually, the topic, it is not a new one. It is well known that you already learn about the topic, about the heart disease in children since even year one maybe. Year two pun I gave one lecture about the congenital heart disease. And then in year three, you have similar topics as well as year five pun. In every posting, you also have case-based discussion. One of them is about the heart disease kan. It will not be a new one. Most of the slide it will be repetition, but what I am going to highlight is the purpose of this session. Actually, for common lecture, year five, final year common lecture is to give you an insight, to open your mind that you will be a horseman in the near future, soon. So hopefully you will be ready to meet to do the clinical punya assessment kan, the horsemanship. One of them, one of the requirement when especially when you are in pediatric posting, you will have cases of the pediatric heart diseases. It is actually the main purpose, but I believe it is also important that in the nearest future, maybe end of October kan, 2 months from now, you will have final pro. So the short-term goal, hopefully you will be able to pass the exam. Okay. Actually, I want to make a sharing session, but it is quite difficult kan, because I believe aja yang bercakap nih, seorang semua orang akan senyap kan. If possible, anytime you have question, you have comment, you want to what we call it clarify, please just unmute yourself kan. So now berapa orang dah? Oh, the sharing. Okay, so hopefully, it is quite not much. The session is lecture, but actually I want to be more two-way punya communication, sharing session about the pediatric heart disease. So just not remember. I believe you already well known. Well in your mind, but when you examine a child, when we have concern about the heart disease, we just need to classify whether it is congenital or acquired. Most likely will be congenital, especially in infant, until below 5 year old. If it is school age, you only need to concern about the valvular heart disease, rheumatic heart disease as a complication of rheumatic fever. Other possibilities to for your exam to will be unlikely lah. So just focus on the congenital heart disease as well as rheumatic heart disease kalau in children above 5 year old, in school age children. Tapi even school age pun not only rheumatic ya, you will the congenital heart disease still also a possibility. Okay. So regarding the pediatric patient, children with heart disease in the exam, though, most likely itulah the problem tuh. If you are late, macam ngebunyi aja. Someone cannot be a host ke? Yang can unmute the joining and apa namanya living punya partisipan.
Tak boleh doktor sebab dia automatik.
Itulah. Bapaknya soundnya boleh hilang tu. Kalau lambat bunyi pula keluar masuk, keluar masuk. Okay, so for the heart disease, for the exam, ya, mostly congenital lah. Yang rematik itu jarang. Now you don't have short case kan, for the clinical you have even OSCE pun most of the time we will request for communication lah for pediatric. Most likely you will only meet case of heart disease in observed long case ya, whereas which is you need to both examine, do a proper physical examination, and interview ya, history taking. So don't forget about the timing ya. Timing is for observed long case will be given 40 minutes ya, for the final probe. So again, yeah, as usual for physical examination, try to finish in 10 minutes. So you have more time for history taking, to interview the parents, 15-20 minutes. 15 minutes, siap. Yeah. And by 25 minutes, we have another 15 minutes to discuss. So from that, the marks will be given. Yeah. So the marking about the history, physical examination, diagnostic ability, investigation, management, as well as interaction of the patient on this that six item yeah, for long case. So just be prepared about the management, not only how to get the diagnosis, how to answer, but also the exam punya strategi itu kena ada. For the heart disease, day, your first of all, of course, please practice with proper technique. Yeah, every time in clinical session with me, I always ask you to do yeah, to practice. Yeah. In year three, I nak cetulkan technique. Yeah, so make sure your technique is right. Year 5, I hope tak ada problem lagi buat the teknik, buat the steps. So hopefully you will be able to get the findings. Yeah, don't miss the findings. So after you get the findings, so only after that you will be able to diagnose. Yeah. It's all about the long case. But kes-kes with heart disease. Belum lagi pasal yang lain, pasal apa nama yang common mistake in OSCE itu yang I notice kalau yang history taking you tak prepare in 10 minutes to summarize and present, itu yang tak terbiasa, lalu ditanya dulu untuk present baru present. It's, in OSCE itu ada 10 item for marking. Jangan hanya interview and get the diagnosis, itu only two items, yeah. Only two 20% of the marking scheme. Bukan for OSCE. Kalau communication memang tak ada present, you just finish all the the communication, the session with the patient to explain about the disease, the treatment, the procedure, and so on and so forth. So go back to the heart disease. It is for congenital, it is still same, yeah, remain the same. Please don't forget to go to the library and read those books at least, yeah. The nation, you know this protocol, most of you have, but the pediatric cardiology too, I believe you don't have. Go to library, or nowadays actually yang pandai IT itu, you sometimes you may get the PDF for free. 7 edition ini tahun berapa ya pun tak ingat dah. Tak lama tak buka buku. Okay, this is the normal punya apa nama anatomi. Always you can remember, understand the normal. Only after you understand the normal, you will be able to recognize the abnormality. If you understand the normal, including hemodynamic, including the flowing of the blood from artery, goes to the systemic, and then venous return, goes to the heart again. Artery from the left is aorta, the red one will be in behind the pulmonary artery, yang the blue one. Aorta to ascending, dia akan cross from left to right, and then aortic arc normal will be left aortic arc, left side, left direction from right to left, and then descending aorta. This is the blood flow. Venous return from IVC and SVC. Venous return get through liver. So patient with heart failure, don't forget the features. Kalau dia right congestion, dia akan dia congested. Venous return in SVC, you will find increased JVP. From IVC, you will find hepatomegaly and pleural edema. From left pulmonary vein return punya congestion, you will find bilateral crash and tachypneic respiratory distress. That simple understanding of hemodynamic, you paham bahwa venous return yang systemic from IVC, SVC yang pulmonary from the lung. Simple aja. Once you remember, understand, you will always remember. The pressure pun will normally higher pressure on the left. So if there is defect, AST or VST, there should be a left to right shunt. Even PDA pun sama, aorta and pulmonary artery should be higher pressure on the aorta. So should be left to right shunt. Which will show a non-synoptic or asynoptic congenital heart disease. Patient will still pain. Yeah. Always, I always, when you do a physical examination, I always encourage you to see the patient, observe the patient, check dulu. Patient is pink or blue. Yeah. Always understand about that. Still pain, hanya asynotic congenital heart disease dia. So patient not don't have any cyanosis. So macam tadi lah, VST, AST, PDA, so pain. Vice versa, kalau patient nampak biru, clubbing finger, so maknanya higher pressure on the right heart. So it is not a simple AST, not a simple VST, not a simple PDA. It will be complex. For example, TOF, nanti later you will see, yeah? TOF, and then PGA 5Ts, remember, yeah? in physical examination, kompleksnya you cannot diagnose unless you are very confident to diagnose TOF, boleh clinically. For others, we cannot diagnose which one is it, TGA or TAPVT or tricuspid atresia or truncus arteriosus, we cannot diagnose clinically. We only get the diagnosis after echo. So that's why clinical diagnosis, it will be complex cyanotic heart disease. Kalau TOF confident, you sebut TOF boleh. Tapi kalau nasih, you sebut you complex cyanotic heart disease. So it is simple, but only understand this apa scheme, this picture ni, you will know which one is acyanotic, which one is cyanotic. First thing, you tengok color. After you describe the color of the patient, there any most common complication, any heart failure, respiratory distress, actually when we examine the patient. Then also related to any syndromic. When you check the cyanosis, you check central, peripheral, you ask the patient to open the mouth, don't forget to check the oral hygiene, dental, and throat tonsil hygiene as well. To be aware about the IE, because patient with heart disease most likely have high risk of IE. Not all, kan? Ada yang high risk, ada yang moderate, even ada yang low risk, ya. For example, ASP, simple ASP itu usually low risk lah, tak akan jadi high risk IE. It is for the embryology. Oh yeah, I just want to clarify, this afternoon only my session, is it? No other lecturer, is it? That's why kan memang I purposely ask for 2 hours. Supaya tak ada, tak rushing sangat. Kalau only 1 hour, entahlah rushing. Saya just baca je, you all dah just tak tahu dengar ke tak, tidur ke tak, pun keluar masuk pun saya tak tahu lah. So, remember, always remember the hemodinamik, ya. Supaya tahu ni cyanotic, cyanotic tu dah tahu dari awal, mula-mula awal, oh ni cyanotic, ocean pink. Kita akan lah you diagnose TOF, you will never diagnose TOF, complex cyanotic heart disease, because patient is pink. Nah, kalau you jumpa patient cyanotic labing, ya, diagnosenya kalau complex cyanotic heart disease, or maybe TOF if you are confident. So it is common actually in children, ya, not rare. 8 to 10 per 1,000, actually 1 in 100 lah average. So, kalau nak senang cakap 1% of the delivery newborn baby, ya 1% pasti ada heart disease from this varying from the simple sampai yang paling kompleks. Simple macam VSP, kalau simple, no complication, we expect dia boleh tutup sendiri. ASD maybe we don't detect pun. Beda besar, especially yang female tuh kalau udah pregnant baru nampak failure symptom, baru buat echo, baru tahu ASD. Itu common ya, tentu. Kalau PFO itu lagi lah, tak nampak ya. PFO usually will be asymptomatic, no complication, even sampai tua pun tak tahu, even I don't, saya pun tak pernah echo myself, I don't know whether I have PFO or not. Okay. Anita minta clear tanya ya. Nah, ini percentage ya. So from every slide itu, I hope you can grab some message lah, bukan hanya baca. Kalau you baca macam ini, pening kepala, after this you lupa pun. Apa you learn from this slide, remember most common PSP. Kalaupun you paling tak tahu, paling teruk pun your performance tak tahu apa nih, dah pening kepala, you blank, you apa black out, kalau black out you pengsan, saya exam kan. You have apa namanya dia blank tuh. semua hilang pun, jawablah ke estimate possibly ya. You have 30% correct, one out of three hadiths will be TSP. Most common. Okay, this one yang I explain to you just now kan. Left heart pressure will be higher than right aorta, systolic, diastolic. Ini yang PA, systolic, diastolic. Left ventricle compared to right ventricle, left atrium compared to right atrium. So higher left compared to right, unless in fetus intrauterine to right yang higher, even several hours, maybe in the first one or two days pun sometimes right still higher ya. Tapi kalau vigorous normal baby itu after birth tuh kalau dia udah crying vigorous, well baby udah menangis tuh usually it will rapidly reduce the pulmonary pressure, dia akan cepat turun. Kalau yang problematic baby sampai few hours maybe few days ya higher on the right pressure ya. Ya, ini actually kalau nak compare, actually more common asynotic compared to synotic, 7 to 3 kan, itu lebih ini lah, around 7 comparison dia 7 to 3, 2 to 1 lah. 3 baby yang hadisis, yang 2 synotic, yang biru 1 gitu ya. Bukan 1 to 1, 1 to 3 to 3 ya. Okay, di asynotic always left to right shunt. Contoh saya sebut. So how do you know whether it is apa which one it is? So di samping yang ini ada lagi ada possibility juga PS, AS, OA. Ya. So how do you know which one most likely? Tengok di blood flow pulmonary. Kalau yang this one increase pulmonary, how do you increase pulmonary? Usually patient will easily clinically easily develop heart failure. Bukan easily lah, commonly the complication will be heart failure. Bukan all lah ya. We know that AST usually asymptomatic, unlikely develop complication. Tapi kalau ada complication, usually due to increase pulmonary blood flow will develop heart failure. Respiratory distress, congested, itu increase pulmonary blood flow. Easier if you get the X-ray, but usually kan kalau exam itu kita tak tunjuk lah X-ray, unless kalau ortoan. Which case ini jarang kita tunjuk X-ray. Kalau kita tunjuk X-ray akan nampak lah whether increase or not pulmonary blood flow. Apa namanya perihilar vascular marking itu nampak putih sangat ke ramai kita sebut ya. Plethoric lung, or kalau yang ini oligemic lung, reduce. Kenapa reduce pulmonary blood flow? Due to the obstruction, especially PS. PS will obviously reduce pulmonary blood flow. So well known, PS ini jarang sampai heart failure. Kalau AS dengan COA ini yang obstructed kan left heart, not right heart. Yang kalau yang obstructed pulmonary, PS, unlikely develop heart failure. Kalau obstructed systemic, PS dengan COA, dia sama juga, unlikely heart failure juga. Tapi we don't know di lung oligomy itu tak jumpa kalau PS dengan COA. So, tuh dia how you go more deep. Oh, patient pink. Oh, nampak distress. Kata kalau nampak distress ya, tak akan lah dia koa atau apa, PSAS ini. Kalau distress yang heart failure ya. Okay, VST is here. Semua dah tahu defect kat sini tapi tak paham. Left to right shunt. Kenapa dia apa? Heart failure ya, sebab kat sini apa namanya blood overflow right heart jadi congested, jadi hepatomegali beda lima, jadi ini increase CVP. Yang sini kenapa jadi tachycardia and tachypnea and bypass heart attack juga, because when the blood goes from left to right shunt, the left ventricle will try to compensate with increased contractility, increased muscle hypertrophy. Hypertrophy, jadi smaller compartment, jadilah congested juga, venous return from the pulmonary, sama juga akan apa namanya right and left heart congestion juga, jadilah heart failure. This one type ini not for the exam lah. As long as you know most common dari membranus kan. Kalau dia maskular, nah ini understand the histopathology ini will help you to understand to explain to the parents kalau jadi dokter nanti ya. Nah, kalau maskular VST ya teman-teman, sini dulu. Nah ini. Kalau muscular VST, muscle punya development, dia akan growing cepat. So, high probability muscular VST ini akan close spontaneously, tetap sendiri, tak ada apa-apa. Kalau membranous, yang most common is membranous kan, PM VST. Depend lah, because membrane ya boleh dia ada apa growing of the soft tissue itu akan close, tapi tengok size juga, kalau very big kan ya tak sempat tutup, dia jadi heart failure dulu. Yang dekat-dekat the valve ni macam outlet, inlet, nearer to the valve, less likely to regenerate the tissue tu. Especially akan growing tissue tu akan slow. Because high connection, high activity of the valve tu. Dia habis energi tu untuk buka tutup valve, opening and closing the valve. So untuk growing, untuk tissue punya growth itu sikit. So jadi kalau apa as a clinician kalau jumpa yang outlet inlet ya prepare dari awal-awal. Jarang susah nak tutup, tapi kita tunggu if no heart failure. The most common apa most concern complication yang satu of course heart failure, second kalau for long term ya patient jadi FVT kan, jadi budak yang kecil kan ya di small tiny, because increase metabolism habis energi untuk apa heart punya pumping tuh. Kalau dan develop complication, failure, FVT, ya we need to close. So that's why only after that we need to go for the closure to. Jangan need to replan question. Oke, ini ke SD ya. Small, moderate, or large itu depend on the size. Ya. Kalau small, ya less than 3 mm. Contoh tadi, we expect almost all. Ya. Even though yang outlet, inlet pun kalau dia small, we still boleh expect untuk close. Ya. Pun yang dekat-dekat wall pun. Bukan yang muscular only. Ya. Ini percentage ya lagi besar ya lagi higher chance to close lagi older the patient ya. Kita lihat discuss regardless location satu size ya kalau small ya. Of course with adequate nutrition ya don't forget the tissue growth. Ya, depend on the nutrition, the adequate nutrition, cukup growing. So, how we doing the adequate growth, ya tengok the weight increment, berat dia naik, okay, tak ada FTP, ya dia akan tutup. So, usually, the nama kita tunggu kan, kita tak buat apa-apa, usually just echo, observe. Inform the parents untuk tunggu usually kan sampai 6 years nih. Kalau sampai 6 years tak tutup only 10% chance kan to close. 6 years tak tutup ada or with any other problem complication ya we do apa closure ya. Jarang yang apa close after school age nih. Usually kan by 6 years old ya. So nama kita tunggu nih expectation ya bukan we don't do anything ya. We monitor we observe we do routine regular EEG 6 monthly usually kalau kecil ya. Namanya expectation kita expect to close spontaneously ya bukan no treatment ya If you answer no treatment, it is wrong. Small PSD, treatment ya expectation. Itu penting ya. Kalau moderate, 3 to 5 mm, tengok location tadi, muscular still high chance to close. Kalau yang dekat valve, susah lagi nak close. Sometimes ada heart failure, sampai pulmonary hypertension. Sometimes FTP tadi ya. Kalau besar, unlikely to close. Saat kalau dia size besar, dia tutup sendiri. Ya. Tissue close yo. Bukan apa dulu tapi kalau saya bukan saya lah my friend pun ada yang tak paham kenapa boleh itu bukan kalau saya jantung lagi besar apa defect lagi besar ke bukan ya yang the tissue growth itu is to all direction jadi contoh this defect this hole bukan macam ini besar di atas including direction into to the center. Central direction pun ada, dia akan growth juga sampai close. Ya, udah hopefully paham. Nah, ini yang nanti apa? Exam jangan miss yang this one. Ya. We expect patient still pink. Murmur is on the lower left lateral edge. Pan systolic. Jadi kalau dengan member sebutnya grade 3 lah. Kalau grade 2 soft ini jarang yang dengar. Saya pun boleh miss. Ya. Okay, ya, location and then kalau nak describe radiation over the entire precordium ini tak penting lah. Yang penting location tuh lower left, and then left to right shunt, and then don't forget same location ni, location of the auscultation ni is same location with the tricuspid valve. So differential dia is tricuspid regurgitation sama juga same location, same murmur, same apa timing of the murmur pansystole. Tapi jarang, and so that's why our consensus we mention as lower left bukan. Tricuspid area, even same location. Because most common, 30% will be the ST of the heart disease. Yang TR jarang lebih less than 5%. Okay. Ini lebih bit how to auscultate. So, first thing to do is to hear the first and second heart sound dulu. Pastikan dulu lep-lep-lep you kenal, baru you tahu, oh, this is systolic murmur. This is pan systolic murmur, location ke mana. Okay. For the AST is higher on the atrial septum. Still sama, left to right shunt. Murmur, kalau if you hear the murmur, also systolic, but remember tadi the hemodynamic, the pressure. Ya, kalau ventricular pressure is higher kan. Left ventricle 120 systolic, yang right ventricle only 20. So the difference too is around 80-100 millimeter mercury. So the flow will be fast, rapid. Kalau small defect, high turbulence, higher pitch sound, dengar murmur, suara keras. Tapi kalau ASD, beza dia only sikit je, maybe yang left atrium only 20, less than 20, right atrium less than 5. So blood to flow will flow slow from left to right to. So turbulence usually tak dengar sangat. So that's why commonly we miss ASD. Kalau ada pun systolic murmur actually not due to the ST murmur, but due to this relative pulmonary stenosis, due to excessive blood flow to the red atrium, red ventricle, nah, sini cepat-cepat berebut masuk pulmonary artery, jadi turbulence kat sini. So it is systolic murmur on the pulmonary area. So it is same findings, yeah, with PS also. ejection systolic murmur on the same location. Kalau ini memang betul-betul pulmonary stenosis. Kalau AST kita sebut relative PS. Actually tak ada pulmonary stenosis, but we hear PS murmur. So different dia, kalau AST you will get the wet and fixed, ya, split of the second heart sound, the closure of the aortic and pulmonary valve ini akan ada split, bukan lepdep tapi lepdep to sound of the second heart sound, ya. Split. This one, if you understand the hemodynamic, you will understand, you will remember lah. So that's why I can explain this now too, because I understand. So I don't forget dulu dari undergrad, semester sampai sekarang sama. No need to change the knowledge too. Okay. Kalau ESD dia secundum, primum, and sinus venosus ini dekat dengan atrial septum, high dekat dengan location of the pulmonary vein. Sinus venosus kan close to the PV. Ya. Kalau primum tuh lower, close to the apa namanya kita sebut cushion. Close, ya, close to the ventricular lah dah. Kalau sekundum nggak tengah-tengah. Okay, this one not for clinical lah, for the echo. Okay, ini closure dia not always surgery, bukan selalu torakotomi buka apa sternum. Sometimes kan transcatheter through the femoral vein. Boleh right, boleh left, sama aja akan masuk juga to the abdominal aorta, IVC, sampai to the right atrium. Masa kita bawa nih, sorry, macam ini aja. So, then you, if you can imagine an umbrella tuh, we deploy the umbrella tuh ke sini, kita lepaskan, dia akan kembang, inflate, then close. Dia ada two layer, satu layer from the left atrium sac, satu layer from the right atrium sac. Usually kalau yang sekundum ST akan senang, dia akan jepit dua-dua apa muscle from the above and the below of the defect. Not only ST ya, VST pun sama, PDA boleh sama juga prosedurnya. Tapi kalau PDA, kalau contoh kalau VST ya from here turun lagi from the right ventricle. Kalau PDA habis after through the tricuspid valve dia masuk lagi passing the pulmonary valve mencari the PDA ke sini. How to close transcatheter with device ya. Ini yang PDA, always only PDA yang ada, continuous murmur, dua-dua systolic and diastolic. Location here ya, far above the apa namanya left upper left sternal edge atau you sebut left subclavian bawah tulang selangkangan. Okay. Ini pressure dia di aorta 25, the aorta ada 20, pulmonary artery 25, so will be rapid flow turbulence. Ada yang sebut machinery. Okay, PDA ini, nah, kalau yang lain tuh regardless kan, term preterm pun boleh aja. Kalau preterm baby, we expect intrauterine actually there is ductus arteriosus kan. After birth kalau term baby dia akan close. Tapi kalau preterm baby tak sempat lah nak close, baby dah lahir dulu kan. So that's why it is more common PDA in preterm babies. So kalau you jumpa PDA in preterm babies, kita tak terus tutup pun. Jadi ada yang kita sebut hemodinamically signifikan, ada yang non signifikan. Yang non signifikan tak ada simptom lah, baby sih. Kalau hemodinamically signifikan, kalau nak senang tuh patient ada distress, need oxygen, tak tahu lah thinking, so ada problem lah. So our first choice kalau PDN preterm babies before transcatheter closure tuh kita bagi konservatif ya, kita bagi medication ya, medical treatment bukan operatif ya. We give anti-inflammatory ya, PCM ini even though it is antipyretic ada anti-inflammatory component or activity ya, ibuprofen lagi lah memang anti-inflammatory lagi besar. Tapi complication side effect dia lagi banyak. So that's why usually currently we choose PCM dulu. Kenapa pakai anti-inflammatory? Usually when we give analgesic anti-inflammatory, you remember the arachidonic acid punya metabolism. There is COX-1 and COX-2. Ya. When we give anti-inflammatory, COX-1, COX-2, apa lupa? COX, celecoxib itu apa? Ya COX lah, tapi kalau NSAID ini kan, both PCM ini, ibuprofen ini, dia akan non-spesifik kan, akan menghambat ya, akan work for both COX-1 and COX-2. So, there will be reduced. Bukan kalau no inflammation dia jadi, katanya kan dulu kalau kita paham kalau tak ada inflammation, jadi susah tuh. So, no, when we give anti-inflammatory, it will be reduced prostaglandin production. So, that's why if you eat ibuprofen or mefenamic acid before meal, you will feel stomach kan, abdominal gastric pain, karena reduce prostaglandin, reduce mucus protection, so gastric acid akan sake. Kalau in PDA with reduce prostaglandin, so there will be vasoconstriction. Ductus kan is vessel kan. So you do reduce prostaglandin, dia akan vasoconstricted, dia akan tutup. Formula vasoconstriction. Halo. Salam, ya. Yeah. Itulah lupa baru juga pagi tadi saya remember cari-cari apa nama borang tuh, baru jumpa borang, belum sempat ambil darah lah, belum sempat cucuk. Maybe esok kalau lusa saya ambil darah insyaallah. Alright, thanks. Itulah memang lupa, baru ingat tadi pagi tadi. Alright. Insyaallah. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi. Okay, so vasoconstriction, ductus will constricted and then close. That simple. Yeah. LVST usually larger defect. They are both atrium and ventricular septum defect. Usually atrium there because lower close to the ventricle. Yeah, primum, IST primum and inlet. VST high position dulu, dan usually pun sampai join betul-betul sampai nampak macam apa valve pun ada yang kalau yang teruk sangat valve tuh between mitral and tricuspid pun jadi dua valve ya, macam-macam jadi join valve between mitral and tricuspidnya. Kalau ini memang tak boleh close with, we cannot wait for and give any medication pun, cannot close with apa device, we must do open thoracotomy need CTS ya. Sini besar. Dah, ini yang Tadi three most common usually heart failure. Ini yang obstruction, yang jarang heart failure, especially PS. Nah, kalau stenosis, kan stiff ya, stenosis is stiff. So transcatheter also balloon angioplasty ya. Letak apa? Sama masukkan catheter dan inflate the balloon supaya dia lembek, supaya dia boleh open and close normally. Kalau stenosis itu due to stiff, dia difficult to open especially ya. Masuk kalau close ya close ya kan. Masuk open tuh need higher pressure, so that's why ejection systolic. Yang pulmonary lah dengan aortic ya, ejection systolic. Lalu mitral dengan tricuspid stenosis lain dia diastolik. Tapi kayak lagi lah jarang yang mitral and tricuspid stenosis, tak pernah jumpa ya pun case. Usually failure jadi ini regas and then failure. Kalau yang pulmonary aortic nih, nah dia boleh common ya congenital stenosis. Ini apa nih? Nah ini PA. Kalau only PS kan still asynotic. Tapi kalau udah jadi kompleks macam ini, contoh PA atresia. So kalau atresia only ya patient pass away lah, tak ada blood flows kan. So the patient usually will have VSD, will have right to left shunt, and then right overriding aorta, right ventricle hypertrophy. Jadi apa?
Tetralogy of Fallot.
Kalau jadi macam kita sebut TOF. Oke. Okay. Tapi TOF itu still PS lah, still ada flow nih, even though limited critical kita sebut. Kalau sampai atresia ya kita tak sebut TOF, usually kita sebut PA with VST macam. Kalau TOF itu still stenosis, even though critical. Aortic, nah ini aortic sama dengan PS, tapi lain lagi di samping despite balloon valvuloplasty, kita before that we need to give propranolol usually atau CCB to control supaya tak hypertrophy sana ya, di left ventricle need medication before procedure ya. Okay. Koa is here. You remember tadi ya? Aortic valve ascending aorta cross to the right and then left aortic arch and then descending. Nah, aortic arch ni first branch go to the right arm, second branch go to the head, common carotid and then nanti jadi left and right carotid. Third branch jadi goes to the left arm. So most common will after the third branch nih. So that's why you will get radio femoral delay. Ada juga possibility kak sini kan, before the third branch jadilah radio radial delay. So that's why I always blame you kalau you buat radio radial delay sahaja, malas nak check the femoral artery, you will miss radio femoral delay, you will simply miss coarctation aorta, fail, dah selesai. So don't simply skip radio femoral delay, because koa ini usually ya kita jumpa yang radio femoral delay, bukan yang radio radial. And then next step, if you have patient with radio radial radio femoral delay, next step of not investigation betul apa namanya laboratory ya, bedside investigation actually part of the examination yang kita penting is four limbs BP ya, compare right arm, left arm, and then lower extremities, boleh right or left leg ya. So kalau macam ni radio femoral delay, so high apa upper extremities BP hypertension, right and left arm hypertension, yang leg normal. Kalau radio radial delay ya hypertension only on the right arm, left arm normal. Nah, simple koa ya, don't forget the radio femoral delay especially And then next step is to check with for limbs PP. Confirmatory, I still need same ya, echo and cardiac cath ya, to make sure all the anatomy itu easier with catheterization. Ya. Kalau yang kompleks usually with catheterization, kalau simple aja with echo dan jumpa settle, boleh measure, boleh sure the location dan cukup. Ya. Oh ya, yeah, I also apa baru teringat ya, yeah, I just also add on ya, yeah, anytime. Okay, even though confirmatory echo cath, but as a doctor, we don't directly refer any case of cardiac to the consultant. Dokter ada patient cyanosis, bagi aja terus. Dokter ada patient murmur, bagi aja terus. Yeah, it is right to do, but non-ethical because ethically because your initial punya investigation, initial management is it is important also. What is the routine one? Yeah, simply order X-ray, order ECG dulu. With ECG kan we will know any ventricular hypertrophy. And yang simple tuh, and maybe some any other abnormalities, prolong PR, and so on and so forth. With X-ray pun akan nampak kardiomegali, some other tadi yang predatoric or oligemic lung. So routine, please do X-ray, ECG dulu routine in all patient. Even non-stable, non-stable ya easier lah in ICU kan, patient dah tak gerak terus ya buat ECG, X-ray pun boleh order bedside. So it is common, dokter patient murmur terus suruh saya buat echo. Nah, saya okay je, tak apa buat echo tapi it is wrong. Ya. Because later pun I also ask PMO untuk buat X-ray dengan ECG juga. Is everyone jadi Hosman pun buat that ya. Particularly kalau stable patient, kalau non stable ya, resus the patient dulu. Oke. Okay. Nah, treatment higher BP more than 20 ya, different dia more than 20 millimeter mercury. Ada symptom maybe headache, but I go epistaxis. Okay, medication ya anti failure boleh, tentu rarely failure tapi we reduce the blood volume juga ya with diuretic. Okay, dah. Now we discuss cyanotic, but the not this blue ini apa nama dia? Mistiknya. Not that blue, the bluish too is in central perioral, lips as well as the tongue and mucosa peripheral. Oh yeah, don't forget kalau you nanti tanya history ya, history taking. Kalau baby cyanotic, it will always cyanos. Will same lah, contoh. SpO2 70 kan, always 70 kan, in normal or any condition, so will always blue. Tapi kalau case yang temporary blue, kalau dia crying biru dokter, tapi kalau tidur oke, okay. Or kalau senyap, kalau dia relax oke. Okay. That actually is acyanotic congenital heart disease, yeah, because patient actually being, but why develop cyanosis during crying due to increase oxygen demand or sometimes ada apa namanya pulmonary punya apa namanya spasm ya. Jadi dia temporary cyanosis. Kalau temporary cyanosis is not cyanotic congenital heart disease ya, it's actually acyanotic ya. Kalau yang blue baby ini ya always blue lah. So kalau Most of the case kan less than 90 actually yang saya notik nih. Tapi kalau less than 80, less, barulah actually less than 85, barulah kita nampak biru. Kalau still 80 to 90 itu, kalau you rajin, year 5, ini year 5 kan, you rajin pergi NICU itu still ada patient TGA itu, tak nampak biru. Saturation dia ranging 85, 87, ya. Tak nampak biru kan. Jadi ya saya notik dah, dari just PO2 less than 90. Normal actually more than 95, tapi kalau more than apa, still 90 and above nih, not always heart disease lah, RSP pun patient pneumonia pun ya, apa namanya, decide kan, asma exacerbation, asma attack pun decide nih. So, okay, this important about cyanosis ya. Cyanosis is not always an emergency. Ini yang you kena pikir ya. Because banyak ramai aja my apa MO Sasmek pun hari itu yang dari TGA patient pun dia panik ya, patient kata di set terus intubator. Actually patient no need intubation pun. Patient kalau with cyanotic heart disease nih congenital even though less than 90 they will compensate, they will be comfortable with that 85 apa persen SpO2, ada yang sampai 60% pun still okay aja patient. Memang benar biru. Cyanotic. Tapi patient okay aja, stable aja, no need intubation. If only cyanosis, cyanosis only is not a sign of emergency. Ya, jadi emergency kalau a group of respiratory distress features, ya this takipnya biru sampai silent chest, nah itulah yang respiratory distress, severe lah, failure lah, yang itu memang you need to intubate, resuscitate terus ventilate. Ya. Cyanosis only, baby still comfortable, ya, no need to intubate. So, itu like ya, oh, cek ya, oh betul, SpO2 low. Tapi patient stable, give trial 100% oxygen, pakai face mask, atau high flow ke apa-apa, bukan nasal ya, kalau nasal will not reach 100% ya. Kalau inteoli itu 5 minute trial bagi face mask, atau kalau inmunisasi boleh pakai high flow, nasal pun boleh atau CPAP pun boleh 100%, theoretically 5 minute, so check after 5 minute, check the arterial blood gas. Kalau patient with cyanotic heart disease, the PO2 will never above 100. Ini aja, this one the hallmark. Simple, ya kan? You check. Give 100% oxygen. Check PO2 never beyond 100, ya, it is hard. Kalau patient desat, you give 100% oxygen, apa, improve. Ya, RSP lah, bukan kardiak. Ya. Usually kan this patient desaturation ya of course with respiratory distress, with tachypnea and so on and so forth. That's how you distinguish it. Kalau patient respi ya you may intubate, you may do necessary oxygen treatment lah. Kalau this one yang cyanotic after 5 minutes, oh this is cyanotic congenital heart disease. No need intubation pun, even be careful ya, nanti actually Anda tak sempat tak nah explain ya. Certain cyanotic heart disease is critical ya, critical congenital heart disease. Apa tuh critical? Actually this complex heart disease, usually cyanotic lah, ada juga yang acyanotic tapi kompleks, yang depend to PDA, patency of PDA, so ductal dependent. Nah, kalau if you give 100% oxygen for more than 5 minutes, for hours, for few days, tak sampai lah few days maybe, ya, ya, pada few days lah, maybe by day 2, day 3, due to high oxygen concentration, it will induce vasoconstriction, jadilah close PDA, close PDA in patient with ductal dependent lesion will kill the patient. So patient die due to iatrogen. So itulah, be careful. sometimes you intubate the patient, you give 100% oxygen, jadi lama lagi salah, it's wrong management. If you patient critical, ya, yang drug dependent, you intubate the patient and then give 100% oxygen, jadilah close PDA, jadilah patient cepat mati. Ya. Nah, kalau patient tak cyanosis but not distress, not intubate, oxygen pun give. If patient stable, ya 21% normal room air oxygen. Kalau ada mild distress pun, nanti ya give not more than 30% oxygen. 25%, okay. You most likely comfortable non oxygen, bun. Be careful, don't cross the PDA. Kalau yang ductal dependent, yang in NICU sekarang tuh nasib baik dia bukan ductal dependent. Ya ada ESD, PDA pun besar, ya unlikely to cross lah PDA. So tak apa dia tak not close the PDA. The tambon apa already started with prostaglandin, so PDA will keep open lah. Okay. So apa nama tes tadi disebut hyperoxia test. Ya. Nah bedakan ini kardiak or lung. Yang penting kalau jadi Hosman ya jangan panik dulu. Kalau pasien stable, kalau pasien cyanosis tapi distress, ya memang lalu itu be terus. Tapi kalau baby senang, ya apa, napas oke, jangan tak sakit nih. Jadi biru, cek ya SpO2. Try to give 100% tadi. Dan ambil ABG, tak naik pun memang SpO2 memang less than 100 lah. Ini differential ya, yang 50 tadi boleh HLHS juga. Tadi yang PA, VST atau critical PS, kalau critical PS, VST ya TOF juga ya. TORP and so on. Ini pun sama ya, ada yang decrease pulmonary blood flow, ada yang mix atau increase. Nah, decrease tuh ya sama kalau dia pulmonary stenosis. Nah, contoh TOF, unlikely akan heart failure unless under three condition lah. TOF kalau patient TOF yang anemia atau fluid overflow, terlalu banyak IG fluid ya akan heart failure juga kan. Kalau anemia pun dia akan pumping harder, akan heart failure juga. Lagi satu apa ya, lupa saya. Kita sebut pink valor. Atau maybe very mild PS, tapi large VST ya, ya akan pink valor ya jadi heart failure juga. Tapi kalau more apa smaller the apa pulmonary artery, the more critical the stenosis, ya, unlikely heart failure, tapi another common complication apa TOF yang you kena tahu emergency juga bukan heart failure. Oh, jadi Osman kena tahu apa? Come on, nanti next slide. Kalau yang mixed blood flow dia yang banyak something right to left, jadi increase pulmonary blood flow juga akan platelet lung juga akan heart failure juga ya. Oke, okay, yang di, apa yang unlikely heart failure ya atresia, tapi atresia dengan TOF. Ya. Oke, okay, saya explain tadi ya. Ini PS, rate of riding, hypertrophy of right ventricle and right obstruction. Ya. Nih, ya. Nah, that spells or hyposemic spell atau hypercyanotic spell. Ya. So patient TOF kan udah biru, tapi kalau on this condition patient akan distress, lapas laju lagi nampak biru sampai purplish, biru sangat deep blue purplish. Deep blue distress patient in this spell, we must do certain step, ada 6 step lah about the apa resuscitation. Memang need apa oksigen, tapi need morphine to dilate, need apa bicap to normalize the metabolic acidosis, need IV propranolol also to reduce the di flow to reaches di beating itu kan apa heart rate. Apalagi ya transfuse kalau dia apa hypovolemia with apa reduce HP. Sudden onset deepening of cyanosis with dyspnea sometimes ya unconscious ya. Memori dia lagi slow ya, bukan lagi keras. Tapi kan kena compare, kalau slow kerasnya kena compare. You are the treating doctor, udah tahu biasa memori keras ya. Kenapa lembut? Nah, itulah. That's fine. Repair ada two different ya. Sometimes primary repair, terus macam ini buat dilate the pulmonary artery, close the PSD, bawa ke kiri aorta. Simple kan, cakap senang. CPS buat pening kepala. Because not all patient repair, the main purpose ya like this, repair. Tapi not all patient is suitable to do this. Sometimes tak boleh buat in certain criteria lah. Contoh very apa namanya high pulmonary pressure ada pH tak boleh buat. Terus kalau pH we dilate macam ini nanti jadi lagi tinggi pressure itu. So kalau tak boleh buat repair, our very famous procedure is PT shunt. These two person develop intoxic to CPS I think or pitch cardio lah sure. Yang fine CPS maybe ya, yang fine this method to connect between right subclavian first branch ni to the right pulmonary artery, so akan ada left to right shunt kat sini. With PT shunt ini akan left to right shunt, so akan less cyanosis. So that's why patient-patient itu kalau after repair kan dah normal, macam orang normal dah hat. Kalau after PT shunt pun patient dah tak nampak biru dah. Yang common kita jumpa patient yang dah kontrol dah on under monitor STA Dr. Amir. Dah post petisan sampai pasien tak biru, tak biasa je hidup. Tapi ada istilah demamur, ada kalau dua echo ya still TOF punya morfologi, tapi with petisan ya can live normally, tapi kalau develop heart failure apa apa ya we need to repair juga, or later after stable after pulmonary pressure tak tinggi ya we repair juga. Okay, next, tricuspid atresia alone, unable to live, sama dengan PA alone kan. Tak ada blood flow, ya mati. Ya. So, kena ada ASD contoh. Ya. Atau lagi lain, ya maybe PTA pun boleh. From the FEC, ya, kena ada ASD lah usually. Kena ada communication ya. Between right and left, because atresia kan no communication actually from right heart to left heart, tapi kan with ASD dah ada communication. Nih, kalau ada PDA, you must give PGE1. Contoh yang ductus tapi dependent yang critical tu, kalau PDA close ya mati pasien. Unless kalau ASD dia besar. Ya. Yang mix TGA, TPVF, contohnya saya akan cepat ya. TGA senang je, dia tak ada cross ya, aorta from right, PA from left, buat echo nampak cantik ni paralel ni. Tak ada cross tu. Kalau cross tu satu semacam silinder satu bulat. Kalau ini paralel dua-dua silinder atau dua-dua bulat. Kalau you masa buat echo short apa namanya axis akan nampak dua-dua bulat kat valve tu. PA valve dengan AO valve. Kalau buat long axis buat sejajar dengan AO dengan PA akan nampak dua-dua silinder. Ini kalau TGA no intact septum ya, tak ada ESC, tak ada PDA ya, ini another critical, depend on PDA only, you must give PGE1 prostin dan buat surgery. Ini di APVR, so venous return normal kan to the left atrium, ada two from left PV, right PV 2. So sometimes ada, kalau total tuh ya 4-4 nih ya, masuk ada yang infrakardia to the IVC, ada yang masuk to the suprakardia to the SVC, ada yang kardia di APVC itu dia bukan masuk left atrium tapi masuk to right atrium. So yang this kalau total ya 4-4 semua salah kan, bukan masuk RA. Kalau ada lagi yang partial, kalau partial maybe only one or two or three out of four tuh partial aja yang salah masuk ya. Yang ini kan total PV dia jadi satu aja ini. Ayo pening tak tahu gambar nih, PV yang merah nih actually kak belakang jantung masuk sini. So, kalau infrakardia atau suprakardia di APVR atau di APVD ini, congestion dia kan not go through the heart. Kalau yang lain kan congestion heart dia kena involve the heart, ya. Kena ada hyper apa dilatation or hypertrophy. Ada kardiomegali dulu baru failure. Kalau di APVD, it is possible heart failure without kardiomegali. Only this one. Ya. Ini kalau master ya kena boleh jawab, kalau student ya sampai saya tes ya, kalau you boleh jawab ya pandai lah. Tak boleh jawab ya, paham lah, nak examin jadi salah semua. Oke, surgery juga, ini trunkus ya. Trunkus arteriosus, so only one main artery, AO dengan PA jadi satu. Usually VST kan dia akan join AO dengan aortic dengan pulmonary pulse jadi satu, receive blood from both left and right. Ya depend, kalau ini kan cyanotic kan usually banyak from the right ventricle mix. Oke, okay. HLHS nih hypoplastic left heart, ventricle dia not well developed, so no contraction of left ventricle, aorta yang patutnya systolic 120, diastolic 80, dia tak ada. So, karakteristik of HLHS ya ini unis lah. BP dia, hypotension lah. Kalau yang agresif, yang NICU proper kan, any unstable patient, dan terus insert UAV, apa UAC, UVC, check the UA, kalau ada dapat UA pun, apa invasif apa arterial line, terus nak cek BP, terus BP dia tak ada apa BP wave dia tak ada systolic diastolic dia. Oke. Echo dah. Ini yang congenital ya. Jangan lupa innocent murmur, tapi just nice to know ya, innocent murmur itu patient murmur tapi actually normal, kita buat echo ya normal, cardiac heart dia normal, low pitch ya, it is also common, so no, murmur not always sign of heart disease, ada juga patient murmur tapi normal heart, disebut innocent murmur. Berapa nih? 3,5 dah.